Hello and good morning from the Netherlands again. Welcome back for watching a new Satsuki episode. Behind me you can see the Kaho. That will be, let's say, the last one for this year to be pruned, trimmed and maybe repotted. But that will be shown in the next video, of course. First, part one, the trimming of the Kaho. I will flip over the camera and give you a small update of the Matsunami I did 2 weeks ago. So I flipped over the camera and focus a bit more on the Matsunami, which I did the 12th of August, so that's about 17, 18 days ago. So as you can see, on the small buds, already small leaves or buds popping out. So within 2 weeks, it's already recovering very well. The same over here. Already small bud popping up, and the same over here on this branch, and small leaves already. So yeah, another month and it will be maybe full green again. So don't be scared, just do it. The same with the Hanakuranai. So this is now nice, about 9 weeks ago, so it's good. I will turn over to the Kaho. It's a little bit, I already saw a lot of difficulties inside the tree. I will go down and show you what I mean. I will take out the name tag. So as you can see, there are two lower branches crossing each other. So yeah, it's going all the way up. And this is, let's say, the branch I like to keep. The same here, there are almost three branches coming out on almost the same height or in the same direction. The same here. Also, as you can see, two branches and one I like to keep, but first open the tree a little bit more so we can see what's happening. It has a nice S shape with a lot of potential, but first need to open it. So there are the other ones, and that's the one I will do today, only trimming, and then discuss with you what will happening with the branches I don't like to use. Keep watching. Put the camera on the ladder or the standard, so you can have a good view. I try to one layer at a time. I will stop the video and explain a little bit what we see, and maybe how we can solve it for the future to keep it a nice tree as well. So for now, I will put it on time lapse because it could be a little bit boring, of course. See you later. Minutes has passed. I did open the trunk a little bit more, cut out all the dead branches already for the lower part. Now you can see the shape of the trunk, the lower side of the trunk. Here you can see the interference of all the big branches. So the one on the lower part, all the way there, it will be trimmed off in future. But maybe I can make it as an air layer project. The same over here. I got three, four branches in the same way or the same direction. So maybe also some air laying or just cut off. The top actually looks very nice. Only need to take out all the dead branches and trim it a little bit. So yeah, the top is nice, but this part, as you can see, this one is actually interfering the other one. This one is, as you can see, all the way down to this base. So yeah, it looks a little bit nasty with all the branches on the lower side, but yeah, it will be nice. Same over there. 6-8 branches coming out, so that will be trimmed off and cleaned. Same with this, all old rubbish. So keep watching for this update, then continue with the time-lapse. Hello and good afternoon from the Netherlands. It's the 5th of October. Temperatures dropping nicely, as you can see behind me. My Japanese maples are turning into a variety of colors, as you can see. I will update and the previous projects. I will flip over the camera and will guide you through some satsukis again. So you can see it's developing very well. So, see you later. Flipped over the camera. A small glimpse of the other part of my garden. With a lot of maples. Here are some. Behind me are still some. This is a mesu. I think it's 1.3 meters high. This is a normal azalea. This is a normal azalea. This is a vagus. This is the suika, 1.6 meter. I just rotated it because of the sunlight. As you can see, this one is nicely green. And the backside is, yeah, pale. But it will go. Here are the other ones I did last week. Here are some small ones. And here are my cuttings. Developing also very well. This is I still need to do. This is the Yushun. Remember the one which was brown and pale? It's becoming green again. So out of the sun and just some water, that will do. No fertilizer, just let it do its own job. That's another shiho. So 3 times a shiho. Go back to the other parts I did. That's the Hanura Kuranai. It was done in spring, May. You see, it's nice. This is the Matsunami. I did the trim back very well. The one with the broken branch. Then you remember. The Matsunami I did. I must take a look because I write it down. 14 or 15 of August. 14 I did the trimming and the 15 of August I did the repotting. Some people say it's the wrong period of time, but I always say just as long as it's above 15 degrees, you can still do some repotting on your azalea. As you can see, it's doing very nice. Even the broken branch, leaves popping up. Here all. So it's doing good. That one, I don't know what variety it is because it was blooming while I was not at home. This one I purchased when it was half dead. So all this side was all dead. I did not repot it yet. But here you can see there's a new branch coming on this side. So it's good, and for me it's a Neo Hosan. It's really delicate pink with white. So, and here you can see also autumn form some azaleas because they become yellow. Why I potted a spark over there? Well, it's a, I will rotate. It's a triple trunk, so I will rotate it when I will repot it, so it's more
the back branch tilting a little bit more, and I like to keep it white. Also this one, it's good, only some sunshine and it will do good. There's another Meisu. This is the Shiryu no Homara, the one with the hard curly leaves. I always say a little bit of sunshine and you will see all the leaves nice, shiny and dark green, because there is no sunlight. Also well developing after the hard trim back. Here is no leaves, so it's good. Even the bottom side, I will take them away because I don't like it. I just wipe them off before they can start bigger branches or whatever. So the rest I will do later, same as that one. So just keep it a little bit clean and it looks nice. This one I also trimmed, remember, Shiono Seki. It's coming back. And this is the last part, Kaho. I started 4 weeks ago with trimming. These are the previous videos I made. And now the next chapter will be, I hope you can see it, I will make a plastic pot over there and there will be the other one. So I will make a hole in that size and in that size. So it, yeah, a kind of air layer. I just fill it up and leave it there for 2 springs. So it will be there for 1.5 years for sure. So it will develop a root by itself and then I can cut it off. Why I put it like that? Well, it's more easy to transport. The same I will do with this branch. You see, it's interfering the other one, so I will make another pot for this as well. Keep it there for 1.5-2 years. So not next spring, but the spring of 23, I will cut it off. So yeah, sorry, but you have to watch the video again. And maybe some other branches I will take off, like this one. It's a small one, but I will trim it off as well. So I will put the pot there and then I will come back, because I cannot film and put the pot at the same time. Thank you. Some time has passed creating some pots, as you can see. I use everything as a container. So this one will be off. This long one will be off, so it's a 2-in-1. There's another one coming off. I will show you from top side more clear. So there is the one, the main thick branch. I hope you can see it from top side. So that's how we do it. This one is just a pet flat, pet flash upside down. That won't be cut off, and like this. So I will have 5 new cuttings or new trees within 1.5-2 years. I will fill up and we'll come back the results. So I did fill up the 5 containers. I will slow down. Now, here you can see there's another one. So this is how it looks from the bottom side. This is how it looks from the inside. Here's the other one with 2 branches. So now be patient for 1.5-2 years. So as you can see, even in autumn, trimming and it will bloom perfectly back again. So this is the one which will be taken off. Eh? This is the big branch. So you get more air and a nice layer back as it should be. Okay, thank you very much for watching. This will be for now, I think, my last video for maybe 2 or 3 months, or I will do an update. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.